everyone. We are very glad to speak at RubyConf this year. We will talk about mruby Debugger we are writing. This is the outline of this talk. Today's topic is the debugger. We will talk about why make a debugger, what is a debugger, and how debugger works. First, we talk about our motivation. Next, we introduce brief summary of debuggers. Then, after demo, we will talk about the internals of our debugger and the debugger UI. Before our talk, we have some notice for you. First, this talk is technical, not emotional. And because our topic is debugging mruby applications, we talk about GDB and Eclipse rather than Ruby. But we are not C programmers, nor Java programmers, nor English programmers. At last, this debugger is still under development. This is very prototype debugger. Let's introduce ourselves. My name is Yurie Yamane.
And my name is Masayoshi Takahashi.
And G, our cat, is our mascot. Unfortunately, he cannot travel by air, so he stayed at home during this conference. We team Yamaneko have developed mruby applications and developed tools for mruby. Our daytime job is ebook publisher, Tatsujin Publishing. We publish and sell ebooks for IT engineers. So let's get started. We develop a debugger. We have developed an mruby debugger, but we guess some C Ruby programmers don't use any debuggers. They use tests and interactive UI such as IRB or Apply. You may think mruby debugger is also not important for us. So first of all, we should talk the importance of debugger for mruby. Why do we need a debugger for mruby programming? We have talked about mruby in some conference, including RubyConf last year, OED Ruby Kaigi and OSDC Taiwan. While we make some programs, we notice how important a debugger is. C Ruby programming is usually Ruby programming, not C extension. I think JRuby programming is the same, not Java programming. But mruby is not. mruby is used as a part of C or C++ application. Typical use case of mruby is embedding a language in other applications, such as web servers or database servers. Another typical use case of mruby is for embedded system. These systems use RTOS, real-time operating systems, or bare metal. We have used mruby for embedded systems. We should write not only Ruby code, but also C code. We write mruby gem in C, so we can use LED, timers, and so on. We have started to write C. While writing C, we can use debugger even in embedded systems. But after writing mruby gem and writing Ruby code, we found it is hard to debug Ruby code. This is our sample code. It's a LED blinking sample that's verified with timer and LED classes. When debugging these applications, it is difficult to find problem between C and Ruby with DDB. So we need debugger for mruby. Of course, as you know, there are some debuggers on C Ruby, like Ruby debug or bybug. So you may think porting them into mruby, such as mruby debug, is the answer. But it is partially yes. It partially solves our problem. It helps help development of Ruby part. But how about C part? Should we use what? With GDB and MRuby debug, we don't think it is easy for us. We need another approach. Our approach is making a debugger on GDB. These pictures show what we want to do. We can use the GDB and our debugger at the same time. This approach has both pros and cons. One of the merits is that we debug both C and Ruby. Another merit is easy to develop. GDB is one of the most famous debuggers in the world, so our debugger is very portable. The demerit of our approach is that it is not a standalone application. To use our debugger, we should install and use GDB. Another demerit is that our debugger is a little bit complicated, but it's not a serious problem for us. GDB is so portable and powerful. Okay, now let's talk about what kind of function in the debugger we want to use. Debugger has many functions. One of the most useful functions is controlling execution. When we use debugger, we are a breakpoint. We add a breakpoint at some function or some line. After suspending at the breakpoint, we use stepping execution, such as step into, step over, or continue. Another function of debugger is showing internal status. With debugger, we show value of variables at stack trace. On this session, we talk about two functions, breakpoint and showing variables. This is total picture of our debugger. The debugger has two parts, front end and back end. We use Eclipse C developed tool at the front end. It includes the mruby debugger plugin we developed. Eclipse is connected the GDB to GDB MI protocol. GDB runs the MRuby application. The application has another part of the MRuby debugger. It's used with MRuby by MRuby bytecode and MRuby VM. Now we show demonstration of MRuby. Select MRuby debug from menu. This menu is extended for MRuby debugger. You select this, program is starting to execute in debug mode. If you had forgotten to set a breakpoint, the program has execution ends.
Middle.
見えない。ユーザーへとクリック。あ、できない。ちょっとゆっくりやって。押さない。ユーザーへとクリック and select to breakpoint. You can set a breakpoint on the line.Stopping at breakpoint is like other programming language on Eclipse. An arrow is displayed at current line and line highlighted. And variables name, type, and value are displayed on the mruby variables view. V and num display the value that has executed. Variables thathaven't been assigned yet and show as a new class in the type column. Let's talk about why these unassigned variables are in the list later or not. MVB variables view is created by extending GDB variables view. This is an extended variables view for C.Step the next breakpoint. V is changed value to 3. Then num is changed value and type. Symbol and hash are displayed. Stop in method.We can show argument value. Methods return value can be displayed too.
Now, we explain how mruby works to understand the mruby debugger works. As we mentioned, controlling execution is one of the key features of a debugger. With a debugger, we want to suspend and resume execution. In addition to showing variables and stack frames, we need execution control. We update views when stopping execution.The execution of mruby is the core task of mruby VM. So, if we want to write an mruby debugger, we should understand how the mruby VM works. Before we talk about mruby VM, mruby internals, we explain rarely used functions of GDB. The first feature is GDB MI protocol.When we usually use GDB in our terminal, we use GDB commands, like B as break, C as continue, N as next, P as print, and so on. But GDB has another protocol called GDBMI. GDBMI is a protocol not for humans, but for machines such as Eclipse and Emacs. MI commands are verbose, but it's systematic and easy to pass.This table shows the difference of GDB commands and GDBMI commands. This slide is console log of GDBMI session. We don't describe detail of GDBMI, but please keep in mind that Eclipse use such protocol we are not familiar with. The second feature of GDB are conditional breakpoints.We make a breakpoint with location, such as function name or line number of the file. In addition, we can specify some conditions of breakpoint in GDB. In this slide, the former is the normal breakpoint, and the latter is a conditional breakpoint. I use GDB command here, not GDBMI, because it's simple and short. And if clause is used on the latter condition, to enable the breakpoint. We use this feature for all breakpoints in mruby. The third feature is a calling function. What GDB can do is not only suspending and resuming, but calling C function in the application, even functions which are not called in the application. Also, we can get the value from called functions. We use this feature for showing variables. Now we back to MABBM. The execution of mruby-bm is similar to the instruction pipeline steps in a real processor. Mruby-bm has four steps: fetching bytecode, decoding the code, executing it, and writing to the virtual register to update status. After that, we go back and start again by fetching the next code. This loop never stops while the BM is working. mruby has a hook function. It's called after fetch step. We use this function to implement breakpoints. Code fetch hook is a hook macro made for debugging. mruby BM calls this hook each time after executing the fetch step. Notice that you should define enable debug macro to use this hook. The definition of macro is in bm.c. The type of the variable mrb is the structure, a struct mrb state. It is zip mrbbm. When the call fetch hook macro is called, and if mrb has a hook function, the function is called. This is the definition of the struct mrb state. mrb state holds all status of the mruby-bm. Code fetch hook is a member of mrb state. Enable debug is defined in the mruby-conf header file. This line is commented out by default, so you should uncomment it. We set a breakpoint here to control mruby execution. This is our definition of code fetch hook. In this function, we get the file name and line number. So when we break here, we can know the current line number and the current file name that mruby is executing now. But we want to use breakpoints at the C level, not the Ruby level. We should convert Ruby level breakpoints into C level breakpoints to use on GDB. For example, we want to make a breakpoint at line 12 in foo.rb. Our solution is making a conditional breakpoint. Line number and file name at Ruby level are used as a conditional location at the C level is in the code fetch hook function. This conversion is a key point of our debugger. By the way, mruby has a bytecode compiler called mrbc. In some cases, we use only bytecode, not Ruby source code. Bytecode normally loads the original location, so we should use the G option, which stores the source file name and line number for debugging. There's another tip in the code fetch hook. Each fetch step, mruby-bm fetches one bytecode, but one source line doesn't correspond to one bytecode. In this sample, the last assignment has four bytecodes, so we need care not to break four times. This slide shows how we avoid it. We save the previous file number and line number and compare with the current one. If it's the same line and same file, ignore break in this step. We explain another feature of mruby debugger, a variable view. How do we get value of variables? As I said, GDB can call C function. We use this feature. We add new function to get local variables. one function to get a list of variables, another function to get one value. These functions are not called in mruby applications, only called from GDB.
Okay, now we explain front end part, the UI of our debugger. As we show, we use Eclipse as the front end. Eclipse is famous as a Java IDE, but it's used as a C IDE. This picture explains the three layers of our front end. Eclipse platform has a general debugger framework, DSF and DSF GDB packaged in CDD usage. Our mruby debugger plugin is built on top of them. Eclipse CDD is C and C++ development tooling. CDD has many tools, such as parser, indexer, editor, builder, and so on. It is similar to JDT, Java Development Tooling, using Eclipse standard frameworks. Of course, the debugger in CDT also uses the Eclipse debug framework. This debugger service framework is a new framework of CDT. DSF is more flexible than the older framework called CDI. DSF GDB is a reference debugger implementation using DSF. We use and modify DSF GDB to support mruby. mruby debugger on Eclipse is composed of several components. The components are breakpoint manager, editor, variables view, GDB adapter, and so on. This is a screenshot of Eclipse. We see breakpoint marker on the mruby editor and mruby variable view. Remember the picture we saw previously. We need to convert Ruby breakpoint into C breakpoint in our plugin. mruby breakpoint manager provides this conversion. Typical breakpoint managers like C or Java use attributes of Java marker object as is. But mruby breakpoint manager uses attributes of marker object at condition, not for the location of breakpoints. All location of breakpoints are fixed at hook functions. Let's look at another function of the mruby debugger plugin, mruby variables view. Variable view is a standard function in Eclipse. It shows names, types, and values of variables. When the value of the variable update, it is highlighted. Standard value view class provided this feature. So mruby variable view do the same feature without any coding. When debugging C code, GDB returns local variables directly. Then GDB returns list of local variables. But GDB doesn't know how to get local variables from Ruby. So we use GDB function to execute a C function. This function gets locals, returns strings, like a list of local variables in C. So Eclipse can use the same parser in CDT to pass the return value. This is how to get local variables in Ruby. As we explained, ECS use GDBMI. GDB commands we use on the command line, and GDBMI commands are different. For example, when we get local BIOS, we use info locals. But in GDBMI, we use a command stack list locals. In mruby, we call a C function. Calling a C function command in GDB is data evaluate expression. This C function we use is get local. So all commands are like this. This slide shows how to get list of locals value in C and mruby. The result value of mruby is similar with one of C, but because result in mruby use string, lots of backslash are used. We show another GDBMI sample. Eclipse CDT does not get all values of variables at once. CDT have a way to get values of variables by name. In GDBMI, a variables object is used to do that. It can be only used by GDBMI, not command line GDB. For mruby, we made a function getLocalValue. It's a simple function. It takes a variable name and returns a value. Now let's see the detail of the mruby debugger. We can launch mruby debugger from the menu. This is a sample mruby code we use. Defining the RubyConf class using some literal and creating an object. If there are breakpoints, the debugger is suspended at the first breakpoint. In this situation, assigned to variables v and num are done, but reassignment to num is not. We can see variables in the mruby variables view. V is 2 and num is 1. Another local variables are not used now, so currently they are nil. After the assignment to the break the variables num, num becomes 3. Because its value change is highlighted. When V becomes string mruby, its type also changes from fixed num to string. But variables view class supports only value highlighting, not type highlighting, because C and Java's variables not change. To show the result of the value, we simply use the inspect method. So it allows symbols, array, and hash object. We can use breakpoints in method definition. In a method definition, method arguments are kind of local values. So they appear in value view. Of course, user defined class can be seen in the variables view and can be highlighted. When we use the p method, we can see the result in the console view. These values are same as displayed in the mruby variables view. Okay, let's summarize this talk. We have implemented mruby debugger on GDB. This debugger has fundamental functions for debugging, such as breakpoints, execution control, and showing variables in Ruby. But we still have a lot of things to do. First, we have not implemented mruby stack trace view. Current stack trace is C stacks, same as CDT. We should prepare another stack trace view, like the values view. Second, C part of our debugger is tightly coupled with the application. We will rewrite it as mruby gen. When we do, we can use it from other front end. Third, supporting step execution. Our debugger can only do suspend and resume. Lastly, our mruby values will support only local variables. We will try to support instance variables. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.